Hi everyone, in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to get video in your Bubble app. The very first way that I would suggest is to use Bubble's video element. So I'm going to grab this here on the left and then just draw it on the page. This player supports videos from three different video sources. So you can work with YouTube videos, Vimeo videos, or Zigio videos. Now Zigio is only going to become available here in the player if you have the Zigio plugin installed. Zigio is just another video service that lets users record and upload videos, so you would have to create an account with them and enter an API token in order to have those videos connected to your account. But that's going to be a specific use case for Zigio, so if you're just working with YouTube or Vimeo and have your videos hosted there, all you need to do is enter in the ID number of the video. Obviously you need to select your source, so YouTube or Vimeo, but you'll need to enter in the ID number here. So for example, with YouTube, I can grab that ID up here in the address bar, or if I go to share a video, I can grab it here from the share link. It's just this last portion of the URL. So I can copy that and paste that in here. And you can see that this ID can also be a dynamic value. So you can save IDs to your database and you know, do a search for them that way and pull them back if you want this to be more of a dynamic player. You also have options to play the video automatically once it's loaded. You can replay it once the video is over. I believe different sources will give you different options there. So you can see with Vimeo, you also have control over the color of the control bar at the bottom of the player. Also with Vimeo, just wanted to point out where you can find the ID also in the URL. That's going to be the easiest. You can share as well and get the ID from the code here. And it would just be these last numbers here at the end of the URL. That's the ID. Now, a second method for playing videos is to use an HTML element. So this will give you more control if your videos are hosted somewhere other than Vimeo or YouTube. So I'm going to grab this HTML element, place it side by side here. So if you have your video file saved to your Bubble database or saved to a Dropbox or some other cloud storage service, this is going to be the element that you'll want to use. If you go over to, I'm going to add this link in the description for the video below, but this is a really great tutorial site for HTML code, and they've got a section here on HTML5 video. And what you want to look at is really just this video tag. At the very least, you really just need to provide the dimensions of the video. This is going to be for the player, and then the source. So you need a URL here somewhere that your, wherever your video is stored online. So I've actually got a piece of code here that is using that. So I'm just going to go into this HTML element and paste that here. And if I open up the HTML editor, just to be able to see the code a little bit better here, I can see that basically what this is an iframe tag. I've defined the width and the height of the player. So width is 560, height is 315. I'm going to close out of that for a second. And if I, as long as I make the HTML element the same width, so 560, 315, then the player should fit nicely inside of that element. You know, if you see if I expand this, that the height is only going to be whatever I set in the code there. So that's something that you can play around with, but rule of thumb, if you want to just keep everything neatly squared away, just make the height and width the exact same. Other pieces for this code here, we've got the source of the video, so you can see that I've actually got my YouTube embed URL there, but this can also be a file that's saved to my Bubble database. Maybe it's a file field or a Dropbox URL. This is why the HTML method here for displaying videos is helpful, because you don't, I mean, you can work with videos outside of YouTube and Vimeo, because you're really just loading up a video that is hosted somewhere online through its URL. Okay, so this would be the most basic setup for it. Again, this page goes over a lot of different options that you can add, such as autoplay. It also lets you know which browsers support this method. Most browsers do. Most of the popular browsers and, you know, the most recent versions of those browsers will do fine with this, but definitely check this out if you're seeing any issues. And yeah, there are other properties and stuff that you can mess around with, but this is definitely a handy page where you can test your code as well. So I'm just gonna make sure I have an ID here. This is the YouTube video ID, and I'm gonna preview this page just so that we can see them side by side. Okay, so on the left is the bubble element for playing a YouTube video when I've set it to YouTube source, and the right is my HTML element. You can see the dimensions are a little bit bigger. You can control the size of this video if you just make the element bigger. So this is somewhere where purely making the element dimensions by dragging them will increase the size there. So I'll refresh the page and you can check that out. Okay, so that's obviously easier to work with, but again, the HTML element might give you more options in terms of which videos you can use if they're saved elsewhere on the internet. All right, that's it. If you like this video, leave a comment below or give it a thumbs up. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel to get updated on new tutorials every single week. Thanks so much for watching.